motorists are going to be spending a heck of a lot of time on Interstate 35W in North Fort Worth over the next 3 or 4 years. This entire 10-mile corridor is about to be under construction. And so it seems worthwhile that we ought to share some factoids and tidbits about the project. So with that in mind, here are 5 things you may not know about Interstate 35W.
Number 1.
Muscle exercise.
Over where Interstate 35W crosses the Trinity River, kind of an interesting scientific wrinkle has bubbled to the surface of the 35W expansion project. As part of the agreement to build this project, workers have agreed to remove a special kind of muscle from the water here at the Trinity River. Actually, it's 33 different mussels from 3 species. Luckily, it was determined that none of the species is on the state's threatened list. If they had been, the workers would have had to place computer chips on the mussels and track them for 5 years. The mussels were relocated to Quanah Parker Park in East Fort Worth, about 8 miles downstream. Let's hope the mussels aren't sore about being removed. Anyway.
Number 2.
Western Center Mess.
Since the reconstruction of Interstate 35W began, the area where traffic has been the worst so far is Western Center Boulevard. And for motorists who pass through this area, I'm sorry to tell you, it's going to be this way and possibly worse for several months more.
I did not know they were about to do more work. I thought it was pretty close to being done, actually.
So do you have any shortcuts or any secret passageways you can recommend?
I head down to the back behind, right here on this skinny road right behind the store. It heads down to the service road that you can take, try to get around everything. There's a couple big accidents on the freeway right up there. Just I think a UPS truck got turned all the way sideways one time, just stopped all the traffic. And everything was backed up. They shut down the road at one point.
During the next 6 months, workers will need to widen the road above the Western Center Boulevard underpass to make room for 2 new toll lanes in each direction. They'll also fix the frontage roads, so the congestion on the I-35W main lanes promises to be there for much of the next 6 months to a year. And on top of that, there will be times when the lanes on Western Center Boulevard itself will have to be shut down. Yikes.
Number 3.
28th Street.
One of the first things that's going to have to happen over the next few months is this 28th Street bridge over 35W is going to have to come down. As you can see, it's much too small and outdated for a modern freeway project. It's going to come down in 2 giant chunks so that traffic can still use half the bridge while the rest of it's being demolished. During the days when they need to actually do the demolition, they're going to have to close the main lanes of 35W, move it onto frontage roads, and do the demolition and then put the traffic back. So that's going to cause periodic headaches, especially on nights and weekends.
Number 4.
Why tolls? Why?
You may wonder why toll lanes are being built on I-35W since it's an interstate highway. Federal law has traditionally banned tolls on existing free lanes, although the Obama administration is arguing for a loosening of those rules. But in the case of I-35W, like many other Metroplex interstates, existing lanes on the road are being rebuilt and will remain toll-free. And it's the new lanes, 2 lanes in each direction, that will be tolled. It will be an electronic system with no toll booths, and you can either pay with a toll tag or just lit the camera system on the road, photograph your license plate, and you'll be sent a bill in the mail.
Number 5.
The Interstate 30 connection.
Traffic is pretty much always insane near downtown Fort Worth, where Interstate 30 and 35W come together, Fort Worth Mixmaster. And it's not going to be too long before traffic on Interstate 30 here will be able to take an exit to 35W, jump on the toll lane, and go all the way up to the Alliance area north of Loop 820, or stay on the special toll lanes and go on to Loop 820 and Airport Freeway all the way to the south entrance of DFW Airport. It's more than 20 miles of toll lanes. Basically, you got the dough, you can buy your way out of all this congestion. A spokeswoman for the consortium building the 35W project, Heather DeLapp of North Tarrant Express Mobility Partners Segments 3, boy, that's a mouthful, says it's not yet a done deal that the toll lanes will have a direct connection from I-30 and or Chisholm Trail Parkway, but, quote, it's not a given, but we're confident about it. So that's about all for now. Thanks for nibbling on those 5 news nuggets. If you have any questions about Interstate 35W or any other projects in the Dallas-Fort Worth area, shoot me an email, gdixon@startelegram.com.